Just think, how many presidents looked out that North Portico window at the Andrew Jackson statue for inspiration? A lot. Well, there's one in particular that's most like Andrew Jackson. He actually lives there right now. He's President Donald Trump. And the similarities between him and Jackson did not escape him as he took me and my Fox & Friends co-host on an Oval Office tour.
Why did you put that up?
Well, they say that his campaign and his whole thing was most like mine. It was interesting. That was 1828. They used to go back to Ronald Reagan. Now they're going back to Andrew Jackson. But that's the great Andrew Jackson, who actually was a great general, and he was a great president, but a controversial president.
So President Trump sees the similarities between Andrew Jackson and himself. But what about the historians?
Like Donald Trump, he used the technology of his day. Trump uses Twitter. Andrew Jackson pioneered the use of lithography, which is an artist rendering that's mass-produced. And it transformed politics because they could hand you this picture. Remember, most of America was illiterate. They hand you this color picture. This is mine. This is right. Yours. You can take it. Who's that? That's the man running for president we're voting for.
Right.
His opponent, short, bald, stout, stern looking.
Who are you talking about?
John Quincy Adams. And here's Andrew Jackson, sexy with flowing hair. And what's this? It's the Battle of New Orleans. What's that? He won the Battle of New Orleans. It was as good as TV. So everybody got their own lithograph. So Jackson, like Trump, was into the latest technology.
They're similar in some of their temperamental issues and how Jackson was volatile, could be volatile, and they were both outsiders, but there were different types of outsiders. President Trump was an outsider to politics, and Jackson was a geographic outsider. He was not one of the Virginia aristocrats or an Adams from Massachusetts. He was from the other side of the Allegheny Mountains.
Very much against the elite, Andrew Jackson, as he defined them, because life on the Western frontier was different. He knew that people in Boston didn't really understand what it was like to live in Western North Carolina.
Many say he was the first celebrity in American history. Big crowds followed him wherever he went, and he warred with his own cabinet, like Trump. He warred with the Senate, like Trump.
Andrew Jackson despised erroneous news stories, what we call fake news today. But even more than that, he despised any time his reputation was smeared in the public prints. He would just throw a rage. And he spent a lot of his public career seeking revenge on journalists.
Andrew Jackson loved his wife, Rachel, and when he was elected president of the United States, Rachel went to Nashville to buy a dress with all her girlfriends, and they were in these stores, and she found these old stacks of newspapers. They had hidden them from her, and his opponents called her a bigamist and an adulterer. She was a very religious, devout woman, and it broke her heart. She went back to the Hermitage. She went to bed. She died of a heart attack. She never set foot in the White House, and it broke his heart, and it made him angry. And he organized what later became the Jackson Papers. It was a chain of newspapers, and they were vicious, and they went after their political opponents.
What's fascinating, if you leaf through these, are his marginal notes, where he'd read the paper, and then he'd write comments in the margins. This is good or bad, or there's one article in particular that really took him to task, and there's a great big X through the whole article in ink.
Donald Trump brags on being a counterpuncher. Well, so was Andrew Jackson. In battle, as you know very well, because you write about it, and in politics, and also in duels, and Andrew Jackson was in a duel with a perfect shot as his opponent. He let him shoot first. He opened his chest and said, go for it, and the perfect shot shot and apparently missed. Andrew Jackson didn't even flinch. He coolly, deliberately aimed and shot the man dead. Afterwards, they learned he had been shot 2 inches from his heart, and he carried that bullet till he died.
Up next, Senator Mike Lee says some of the most influential founding fathers have been written out of history. He